So what we do in the process of problem solving, we break the problem, frame the problem statement, solutionize through hypothesis tree, and now it comes to the data science modeling component, right? Data analytics comes here, where we use CRISP-DM as a framework to solve the problem. Now, CRISP-DM framework is what? Let me just quickly show you. I don't keep a lot of time for CRISP-DM usually, because it is something that everyone who comes into data science knows about. Like, it's very standardized. It has like a fancy name, but all it means is just this. You'll understand why I did not keep a lot of time for CRISP-DM in the first place. So once you go through all those three steps, right? You do a MACI framework, break the problem down, first you create the problem statement, then break the problem down, then do the solutioning with hypothesis tree. All of that covers which step in CRISP-DM? This is the 6-step process, guys. This is what CRISP-DM is. You can Google about it right now. On the Wikipedia, you'll find the same thing. This is CRISP-DM framework, which is specifically used to solve data-related problems. What does it say? That to solve the data problem, you first need business understanding. Then you have to develop data understanding. Then you prepare the data. Then you do the modeling, evaluate the model, and deploy the model. Doesn't it look more like common sense to solve a problem? But why has it been put into a framework? So that everyone in the world knows that if I ask Parimal, how exactly will you solve the problem? Instead of walking me through the whole thing that he'll do, he can say, I follow the CRISP-DM framework. And I know what he means. I know that this guy has some structure in his head to solve the problem. Are you guys understanding this? Exactly. And that's a very right, apt question, Parimal. That this business understanding, the first step of your CRISP-DM, has a huge component of MACI. So it starts like the first three steps that we just saw, those are basically more like the step one of the CRISP-DM. And then it continues step two onwards. Does everyone understand this? That the business understanding part, you can imagine, right? That in the process of developing that issue tree and hypothesis tree properly, I'm saying, this is still at a top level what we've done, because we are not considering any data right now. But if actually when you have to solve the problem for a business, you can imagine what level of business understanding will you develop while preparing that issue tree and hypothesis tree. How much will you need to know? How many interviews will you need to do with people, various teams, various business leaders, various process owners, right? So this is the CRISP-DM framework, very simply put. Nothing much complicated about it. Just an example I'll show you here to show you the CRISP-DM framework in action. That let's say you take some raw data, and then based on business literature and understanding, you try to examine that quality of that data using the scatter plots, and you do create k-means and some algorithms you apply to process the data. And then on that data, you will build the model, right? So you do all of the data preparation, then you build the model, you evaluate various options, maybe decision trees, neural networks, logistics, stepwise, all of that you evaluate. And you create the model, and then you evaluate the model saying, hey, what has been, so this is like an example of a classification model. The output for which usually is like a confusion matrix, right? So this confusion matrix tells you how good your model is, how many true positive, how many false positives the model is giving you. And then you deploy that model. And at the end of it, basically you answer the question, which was basically the business problem, that what are the most important factors that influence attendees' intention to visit the festival site? Now this question, which you see, this is coming out of which business problem? The business problem was that who is more likely to visit a particular festival, a food festival in Thailand again. Then you create a case study on intention to revisit, you create a target variable, and then from there, the entire CRISP-DM framework is applied like this, and you come towards the conclusion. And then there are some detailing about this. We're not going to discuss those here, but they'll be available for you guys to reference. These are like hardcore going into analysis of that thing. But do you understand what the CRISP-DM framework is, guys? These six steps and how they will come into play most likely when you do a model using data and prepare data. And after preparing the data for a model, you create the actual model, evaluate how good the model is on training and test data, and then you